Yeah, yeah, girl, come over here. Yeah, yeah, come talk to me. Come talk to me a second, yeah. I'm cocky and single and I got your jeans tingling, girl. With my costly signaling, I'm rocking the rhythm. And all you keep thinking about is the offspring we're bringing to the world. And you're awfully tempting, cause you got my jeans tingling too. With your costly signaling, you're cute, but you gotta be considerate and have a sense of humor, or you will not be interesting. Charles Darwin saw natural selection as the most serious cause of evolution. But what was going on with bird songs and peacocks? They follow mysterious laws. And then Darwin had a curious thought. It probably occurred to him while explaining his theory to a young Victorian blonde whose face displayed a mixture of desire and feverish awe, the immediate cause of which Darwin clearly saw. So he said, "My dear, descent with modification comes from the struggle for survival and reproduction. Hence the reason for some structures must indeed be seduction." In fact, Darwin's brain was probably one such structure. Just as peacock's tails show off the genes of the top males, and likewise the songs of nightingales and the fighting skills of elephant seals and minnows with colorful scales. See, these are all traits that sexual selection has shaped through the female preference to get with the fittest mates. But in human beings, selection goes both ways. Pretty much anything that's just for display and isn't meant to dissuade and chase predators away was probably selected for in a sexual way. But wait, isn't this just such a display? I mean, I really thought I had something to say, but is it just a demonstration of my DNA? And so what if it is? That's great. What's to explain? Okay, maybe a couple of things. First, to say that something ornate like language evolved as a seductive display doesn't mean that people only use it just to get laid. Darwin leaves Freud in the dustbin, okay? I can use a urine screen to put out a fire. That doesn't mean the penis evolved as a bush firefighter. This is a theory of language function, a theory of where it comes from. What it's used for, that's a separate discussion. So which was it? Was language originally a mechanism of survival or reproduction? Well, let me put it this way. Can you talk a predator out of attacking? Can you talk a parasite out of infecting? Can you talk a potential mate into consenting? Potentially, right? Not necessarily, but potentially. Yeah. I'm cocky and single and I got your jeans tingling, girl. With my costly signals and I'm rocking the rhythm. And all you keep thinking about is the offspring we're bringing to the world. And you're awfully tempting, so you got my jeans tingling too. With your costly signal and you're cute, but you gotta be considerate and have a sense of humor, or you will not be interesting. Alright, check this out, check this out. Presenting the grand unified theory of rhyme. The mating mind uses lyrical signs combined with wit and wordplay and conversation and humor in different narrative styles to appraise the fitness of mates, both for the purpose of marriage ties and mates of the more temporary kind. These are the humble roots of the literary sublime. We are all Shakespearean primates verbalizing our cherry behinds. But how could we possibly test this theory of mine? Ideally, we could use experimental holding zoos filled with human subjects, and with an overhead view, we could observe which breeding pairs reproduce and how often they use their verbal ornaments to seduce. We could even separate them into control groups to see whether male or female vocals are more prone to be used to stimulate hormones, although it's true that this sort of experiment on humans isn't normally approved. If only there existed in a state of nature some cultural group preoccupied with making paper and parading naked women, shaking their moneymakers in front of competitive males displaying mating behavior while trading their creativity for sexual favors. If such a group existed, I predict it would be a major player in the entertainment industry and would be in major danger of being overwhelmed by angry player haters. But I may have to save some of my research for later. I'm cocky and single and I got your jeans tingling, girl. With my costly signals and I'm rocking the rhythm. And all you keep thinking about is the offspring we're bringing to the world. And you're awfully tempting, so you got my jeans tingling too. With your costly signal and you're cute, but you gotta be considerate and have a sense of humor, or you will not be interesting. And how do I answer the charge that I'm participating in this mating dance myself with these dazzling bars? That isn't hard. I plead guilty. I worked hard to achieve this ability, and if it also gives my genes visibility, then so be it. But I confess, it also reveals my unique disability. See, my tendency to tell monkey fables and funny medieval tales generally fails to attract any nubile young females. It does attract women a lot, though. All highly educated and postmenopausal. I know, isn't it awful? I get mobbed after my Chaucer shows by grandmas thanking me for making it possible for them to appreciate a hip-hop flow. And you might ask, where are their granddaughters? My guess is they're at gangster rap concerts. But hey, that's how sexual selection works. Any mutation gets tested first, and if it doesn't get spread, then it gets purged. So this experimental hip-hop mix, where it gets crossed with literature and lectures, will probably get the burial that it deserves. That is, unless you spread it like whispers. Come here, I'm cocky and single, and I got your jeans tingling, girl. With my costly singing, and I'm rocking the rhythm, and all you keep thinking about is the offspring we're bringing to the world, and you're awfully tempting, so you got my jeans tingling too. With your costly signal and your cute, but you gotta be considerate and have a sense of humor, or you will not be interesting. Cocky and single, and I got your jeans tingling, girl. With my costly signal, and I'm rocking the rhythm, and all you keep thinking about is the offspring we're bringing to the world, and you're awfully tempting, so you got my jeans tingling too. With your costly signal and your cute, but you gotta be considerate and have a sense of humor, or you will not be interesting. Yeah. Yeah, step into the area. Yeah, you and me, girl, we got different criteria.